They've been campaigning for years, but say they're still being ignored. So the protest was brought to Whitehall, an area of influence with an extremely good bus service. It was an effective way of proving their point.
How can you bring that in?
We have facilities for
disabled people. Have you got facilities for disabled?
No, we don't have facilities for the wheelchair now.
Will another bus be coming shortly?
Will another bus come along with facilities for disabled?
Facilities? I don't think so.
Most bus crews were sympathetic but unable to help. The doors aren't wide enough to take a wheelchair. Veronica had no trouble getting herself on board despite her disability. Her chair was another matter. The protesters point out that buses aren't the only places unable or unwilling to take them, but it adds to their already considerable mobility problems.
The crew seem very friendly, actually, and they're understanding that we're not criticising them. And in fact, the last guy who I spoke to tried to get the chair onto the bus, but of course it isn't possible. I got halfway there, but if I had got on, of course, there would have been nowhere to travel because I'd been stuck on the platform. But...
London buses say they do run special services for handicapped people, though they accept that their existing regular services aren't suitable. They are looking at new designs, which are more accessible to wheelchair users. But again, it's all a question of money. Tricia Ingrams, Thames News.